dear students and friends, my today's video lecture is on Gauss theorem. Dear students, Gauss theorem is backbone theorem of electrostatics. In previous lectures, we discussed what is Coulomb's law, and you know Coulomb's law is applicable only when we have two point charges body. It is not must that whenever we charge the body, body should be in the form of point charge body. So if you want to know the force of attraction between two point charge body, only we can apply Coulomb's law. But if bodies are not a point charge, then between them how much force will act, that we cannot calculate by using the Coulomb's law. Similarly, we have find the intensity at any point due to isolated point charge body. But if a point body is not point charge, then intensity at any point cannot be calculated using that formula which we derived in last video lecture. Gauss theorem is the theorem with the help of which we can find the force of attraction between any two shaped charged bodies. Similarly, Gauss theorem can be used to find intensity at any point due to any shaped charged body. Besides these two, there are other fields in which we can apply Gauss theorem. You know, field lines are hypothetical lines. So practically, we are not in position to find how much field lines will be produced by a charged body. But if we can apply Gauss theorem, we can calculate how much field lines can be produced by any charged body. Similarly, if body is charged, it is not a point charged body. Inside the body, on the surface of body, outside the body, how we calculate field, that is also the application of Gauss theorem. So there are so many fields in which we apply Gauss theorem, and today my today's video lecture is based on Gauss theorem. This Gauss theorem is very important for your future exams. In every year board exam as well as in every year competitive exam, you get the question based on the Gauss theorem. Maybe objective question, maybe conceptual based question, maybe descriptive question, maybe numericals. This year also, in 2020, numerical was asked in the board exam, which was based on the Gauss theorem. So you cannot expect any question paper, whether theoretical question paper or board exam or competitive question paper, without Gauss theorem. So please concentrate on this theorem. Gauss theorem can be discussed only when we know a special topic named electric flux. So my first discussion will be on electric flux. After discussing electric flux, we will see how we use Gauss theorem, how we apply Gauss theorem, what is Gauss theorem and what is its proof. So today's lecture, my first topic is electric flux. Dear students, flux means group or bundle of lines, group or bundle of lines passing through any closed surface or loop normally. Group or bundle of lines passing through any closed surface normally. So if we want to define electric flux, we can say group or bundle of electrical lines which passes through any closed surface normally. That is, electric flux is number of electrical lines passing through any closed surface normally. Numerically, it is defined as dot product of electric field intensity and area vector. Symbol phi represent flux. Phi e means electric flux. So electric flux is the dot product of electric field intensity and area vector. Because lines are hypothetical, we cannot calculate the lines. But how many lines are passing through any closed surface normally, that we can calculate by using this formula. Dot product of electric field intensity area vector. Here, this vector ds is a special vector called area vector. Now what is area vector? Suppose we have a surface, like this is a surface. Maybe surface will be like this, maybe surface will be like this, maybe surface will be like this, any closed surface we can take. Now area vector means such type of vector quantity whose magnitude is equal to the area of the surface and direction normal to the surface outward. If we take this surface into consideration, area vector will act in this direction. If we take this surface into consideration, area vector will act in this direction. For this surface, it is the direction of area vector. For this surface, it will be the direction of area vector. So what is the direction of area vector? Normal to the surface outward. And magnitude will be area of the surface. Suppose we have a body in the form of cuboid. Suppose we have a body in the form of cuboid. So many faces, closed faces consist of. Area vector of this face will act here. Area vector of this face will act here. Area vector of this face will act here. 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 And magnitude will be area of different faces. Always make it clear, magnitude of area vector is the area of the surface and direction normal to the surface outward. This vector is called area vector. So when we multiply electric field intensity vector at any point and area vector at any point, we get electric flux. Since they are vector quantities, so multiplication will be dot product. Always take the dot product of electric field intensity and area vector. So this is the vector method to find electric flux. This method is applicable only when intensity vector at any point is given as well as area vector of that point is given. In scalar form, this electric flux you can write as magnitude of intensity, magnitude of area into cos of angle between intensity vector and area vector. This is the scalar formula of electric flux. This is the vector formula, this is scalar formula. Here theta is angle between electric field intensity vector and area vector. Depending upon the value of theta, there exist three types of electric flux. Number one, if theta is less than 90 degree and greater than or equal to 0 degree, means angle is acute, less than 90 degree, greater than or equal to 0 degree, when angle will be acute, the value of cos theta will be positive, so electric flux will be positive. It is called positive electric flux. Number two, when theta is less than or equal to 180 degrees but greater than 90 degrees, that is when theta is obtuse, cos theta will be negative, so electric flux will be negative. It is called negative electric flux. And number three, when theta is 90 degrees, cos 90 will be 0, so electric flux will be 0, called zero flux. So at a point intensity is present, at that point a closed surface is present, means there will be magnitude of intensity, there will be magnitude of the area vector, but depending upon the direction of intensity and direction of area vector, we will come to know whether flux will be positive, whether flux will be negative, or whether flux will be 0. And most of the time students are not able to understand what is theta. So they do the mistake when they do the numerical based on it, or when they try to discuss conceptual question based on it. So make it clear what is theta. It is the angle between intensity vector and area vector at that point. What, how we measure theta, whether theta is acute, theta is obtuse, or theta is zero, that will decide whether electric flux is present or not. Now unit of electric flux. अगर सिस्टम एम्पियर्स है, इन एम्पियर सिस्टम यूनिट विल बी न्यूटन पर कूलम इनटू मीटर स्क्वायर, न्यूटन पर कूलम इनटू मीटर स्क्वायर. एंड इन सीजीएस सिस्टम यूनिट विल बी डाइम पर स्टैट कूलम इनटू सेंटीमीटर स्क्वायर. एंड व्हाट इज द फिजिकल सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स एज वी डिस्कस इन द बिगिनिंग, इट गिव्स द नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल एंड फोर्सेस passing through any surface normally. So if we are able to understand what is electric flux, now very easily we can explain or we can understand what is Gauss theorem. As I told you, Gauss theorem is very important theorem. It is the backbone of this unit. It can be used at so many places. There are two different methods to state Gauss theorem. First method is number one, closed surface integral of electric field intensity. Closed surface integral of electric field intensity will always be equal to 1 by epsilon naught times total charge enclosed by that loop or surface. Closed surface integral of electric field intensity will be equal to 1 upon epsilon naught times total charge enclosed by the surface. This is the first method to state Gauss theorem, and this is the method to write Gauss theorem mathematically. Once again, closed surface integral of electric field intensity will be equal to 1 upon epsilon naught times what is Q? Total charge enclosed by the surface. If surface is not enclosing any charge, the value of Q will be 0. This is the first method to state Gauss theorem. Now second method, as we discussed just now, this is electric flux. So integration of it is called total electric flux. So second method is total electric flux associated with any closed surface will be equal to 1 upon epsilon naught times total charge enclosed by that surface. So there are two different methods to write or to state Gauss theorem. Closed surface integral of electric field intensity is equal to 1 upon epsilon naught times total charge enclosed by the surface, or this whole is called total electric flux associated with any surface will be equal to 1 upon epsilon naught times total charge enclosed. So these are the two different methods by which we can write Gauss theorem. Now we are going to discuss how we prove Gauss theorem. What is the proof of Gauss theorem? Suppose we have taken a point charge body of charge capital Q, and we have taken a point P at a distance capital R from it. Very easily we can find intensity here, because a isolated point charge body can produce some field here which can be calculated by the formula 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q upon R square. This expression will give magnitude of field here. If we place test charge here, it will be repelled by it radially outward. So if in this direction we take a unit vector n cap, if n cap is unit vector acting along the line away from point charge, then this intensity in vector form, whenever we want to calculate scalar into vector, we multiply it by unit vector. So this will give the intensity vector here at point P. Now if we assume a small segment of area ds at point P, then area vector of this point will act normal to the surface outward, means in this direction. On taking dot product of equation 2 with vector ds, vector E dot vector ds is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q upon r square n cap dot vector ds. Now this is, what is ds? Area of a small patch present at point P. Now if we assume this point at the center and we draw a radius, circle of radius r, then there will be so many patches on this sphere of same area. So on integrating we have integration of electric field intensity into dot area vector for complete truth, so it will be close, is equal to integration of 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square into n cap dot vector ds. As we know, before integrating we keep the constant term outside, so we will get integrate closed surface integral of electric field intensity is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square, because q is constant and radius of this sphere is also constant. Inside the bracket you will get n cap dot vector ds cap, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square. When we multiply two vector quantities by dot product method, we get magnitude of first vector, since n cap is unit vector, its magnitude will be 1, into magnitude of second vector, the magnitude of vector ds will be ds only, into cos of angle between n cap and ds. As shown in the figure, n cap and ds both are acting in same direction, so theta will be 0, so we write here cos 0. Implies that closed surface integral of electric field intensity is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square integration of ds vector only. Since both sides we are taking closed surface, so here we write closed surface integration. Now vector ds, magnitude of ds, ds is the area of this patch. Integration of ds for whole surface will be sum of area of all the patches present on the surface. And when will we find sum of all the area of the patches present on the surface? We get total surface area of sphere, which is 4 pi r square. 4 pi, 4 pi will cancel out each other. R square will cancel out each other. So finally we will get closed surface integral of electric field intensity is equal to q by epsilon naught. This is the proof of Gauss theorem. Now, what are the important applications of Gauss theorem? As I told you that Gauss theorem is very, very important for class 12 electrostatic unit. In so many places it is applied. Numerical form, conceptual form, theoretical form, derivation form, from every side it is important. There are so many applications of Gauss theorem. In your syllabus, few applications are there. They are, number one, determination of number of electric lines produced by isolated point charge body. Number two, determination of electric field intensity due to thin infinite length charge wire. Number three, determination of
electric field intensity due to charged solid conducting sphere. Number 4, determination of electric field intensity due to charged hollow conducting sphere. Number 5, determination of electric field intensity due to solid non-conducting sphere. Number 6, determination of electric field intensity due to thin infinite slash finite length infinite slash finite dimension charge metallic sheet. And finally, determination of electric field intensity due to pair of infinite or finite dimension charge metallic sheet. We have 7 applications which are in your syllabus. In my next video lecture, we will discuss these applications one by one. So dear students, this is all about your today's video lecture. I hope you will be able to understand this lecture. Please subscribe my channel, like and share it so that you can get updates every day. Thank you.